You're going to do nine.
Three times.
It's been a great experience on many levels, really.
It's just very, very challenging.
Construction, speaking to new people.
Blows me away, really.
Mm. I've done things I never even imagined that I would be able to do.
Had an awesome trip.
Shared the gospel with them.
Quite moving to see how people reacted.
Everything we've done this week should be stuff that should just be done.
Playing with the kids at Tinca, how they just accept you.
Greatest 2 weeks of my year, without a doubt.
It's fun sometimes, but it's also boring as well.
Second to none, and we just loved every second of it.
This has been an amazing trip.
Doing our best to be as much like Jesus as we could have been.
An incredible reminder of what Christianity is actually all about.
It's just felt good to teach them. God loves me, I have sinned, Jesus died for me, I must choose to live for him.
The only real love that really matters in this world, which is Jesus' love.
Hopefully something that we did has left an impact.
I think definitely I'd like to come again.
Yeah, life-changing experience.
Well, it's just no words can say. It's just absolutely amazing.
Was it a yes or a no for the mission trip?
Yes!
Dave Truss, is he in the house?
Juliano! I'm coming! I'm so excited
Dave,
you guys are here!
Dave, that dog is barking!
Sarah! I think if the cats needed to meow just a little bit more before I come. I'm like so excited, I'm coming right now.
Good.
You guys are gonna be so tired.
Yeah.
Like literally so tired, Sarah!
You're here!
Oh, no. Oh, bless you.
You're here, Millicent. Oh, I've missed you.
Please.
Molly.
That's going to be
what
good.
What are we going to call her, Dave?
What are we
going to
call her?
Molly-o.
Oh,
Molliano, that works too.
Molliano.
Molicento.
Molicento. Millicento Molliano.
Yeah, I think we need to work on this.
Where's Millicento and Molliano?
Yes, I think that's it. I think we got it.
I like my hug now, trust man.
Oh, I've missed you.
You too, buddy.
You doing okay?
All right.
Did you know you're amazing?
Did you know that you're amazing?
Only when you're here.
Did you get taller? I'm pretty sure you did.
Always happy, Dave is.
Juliana!
Millicento! Molicano!
Juliano! Did you know that you're amazing, Juliana?
Yeah. Milicano, Millicento.
Yes, so I'm Dave. Rachel is our founder. She's an American lady, and I wish you guys were meeting her today. And just having you guys here to encourage and to be amongst the Roma and the Romanians is just such a blessing. So this is a community of people who are used to being abused. They're used to being discriminated against. People will throw rocks at them and tell them, get out of my store. I've had people shouting at our staff.
We went to FMN in Tinca a couple of times to help with the Roman ministry, and just played with them for an hour or two and then shared the gospel with them.
Nelly, I eat your terog.
Playing with the kids at Tinker, how they just accept you and take on the trampoline or want to play with you madly, sort of thing.
It was amazing to see these kids that live such an abusive life be free and so happy just for a couple of hours.
Come to Yama.
Yama.
Yama. Come to Yama.
Roberta.
Я не знаю, да помогу. Как ты тяма? Бубу, ну фото, ну полза, ну полза.
Камила.
Как ты тяма?
Самила.
Самила. Су фото помог.
Just to see the joy that the women and the children have when they have nothing, and particularly seeing the children playing with, you know, broken bikes and, you know, no shoes on their feet, and yet there's such joy there.
Yes, mate. Okay, got you. Alright. Watch the knock, not your ass.
Yeah. And it bounces.
Let me turn the knees straight.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Great.
This is the most
important. Unul dintre voi. Așa. Dumnezeu pentru mâncare. Mâinile împreună și ascultăm rugăciunea.
When my dad Becky Melly were teaching all the Roma kids crisscross at Forget Me Not, and Dad said, we don't deserve God's love. And all of the Roma children just said, da, which means yes. So that kind of hit me.
What's the answer to that, that we don't deserve it?
Jesus died for me.
But Jesus was also there.
Dar Isus era la nunta aia.
Now,
acum,
one day, într-o zi, a man came down the street who had no eyes.
Not just blind,
but no eyes.
Everywhere he went.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
just felt good to teach them because they need it in their lives, and the way that they are living, it's just like they need to know him. So I enjoyed doing that. It was really good.
Cauza asta ca să pot frații ca să se roagă pentru el.
Nu? We can pray specifically for against
the men's ministry is pretty good because we see these people that attack and beat their own families kind of just sit back and think maybe what I'm doing isn't right, but if I want to have a relationship with God, it's not what I want to do.
That was a real special moment because those men were, they're pretty hard to get into and to open up. The Holy Spirit was definitely there that particular night, and he softened their hearts, and they were able to express and to open up to us their hurts and their prayer requests. It's just a wonderful evening.
And when I was 16 years old,
n-am fost dependent de drogul.
I wasn't addicted to drugs, but I used them and I actually sold them.
When we had the men's night, there was this one guy there that had a genuine relationship with God. Apart from Christy, he's like the only guy that seems to really understand what we teach, and he understands the love of God.
Peter is just like us. He's sat round a fire, keeping warm, when a woman comes up to him and says, "You're one of that followers of Jesus, not me."
Și el spune, nu eu.
Peter said, "I'll never deny you." Oh yes, you will, says Jesus. In fact, before that cock crows twice, you're going to deny three times that you even know me. But I pray for you that your faith will not fail you. And afterwards, when you're changed, when you're converted, strengthen the brethren.
A certain young chap's speech to the men over at Tinca, it just showed how mature he was. It made me sort of think, actually, in a way. When I was his age, would I have been able to sort of come out with that? No way.
And so God created the perfect partner for Adam. Wives should respect their husbands, but husbands should be willing to lay their lives down for their wives like Christ died for us, because of how much he loves her, how much he respects her, how much he values her. I will love her with all my heart, respect her with all my heart until the day I die, and I won't hurt her because she comes from God, because God made her.
Hallelujah.
It's awesome to hear you speak like that at 20 years old and be an example for the guys around you.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for today. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you for our friends that have come from England to share their testimony and what God has done in their lives. Thank you for uniting us in your love. Help us in our faith and help us see how great you are, our God. And help us serve you in everything we do. Thank you for changing our lives, for coming in our families. We pray for all our kids, even those that don't know you yet. Bless our brothers that have come from the village that don't know you yet. Help them get a taste of your goodness. We thank you in the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Corey.
Mulțumim, Corey. Sunt
furioși. Mă bucur și eu că am
outside the line.
Hi.
Oh, okay.
People work together to the end goals of what we had to achieve in when we were building and everything.
Yeah, John, get into the crew, Rob.
It's been great practically learning new skills as we've helped to build and work on the houses.
Magnificent work being done by the team already today. They started with nothing an hour ago and they're putting on this first coat render. with they put a mesh on there and then trowel on the render and then wait for it to go off a little bit and then smooth it off.
When we do the next part, it's going to be a long one, and whatever is left from there, we should probably cut it a bit longer so they recover.
The camaraderie between people on the work site was good. I enjoyed the work.
Julian, your waffle is here.
Yeah. The thing I love most to see right here on a site like this is just behind me, there's two dads who are working with their sons and they're all learning together or they're training one another. Fantastic. So really good to see. And people got their jobs here, everybody's got their responsibilities. It's working very well.
Cum să facem să nu ne încurce? Numai pe dedesubt se poate. Nu se poate. Da, stai că nu putem trece.
Don't normally work that hard, but I felt the work in my body, but it was all good.
Yeah, I think I helped bring some balance to that. Neil obviously worked hard, and I try to compensate for that by using the muscles in my mouth rather than the muscles in the rest of my body.
The wood structure.
We don't use, like we use bricks, all of our
houses. Yeah, it becomes more expensive.
Great to be back there working with the team again. Loved every second of it. Things that I loved most was their passion. They haven't lost any of it, their desire to produce an excellent and finished house.
And it's quite interesting to see how well all the lads and girls work together.
Cows. You're a big boy, aren't you?
We're remarkable cows.
Been at the gym, innit?
It's a fabulous show. Oh, you know we are cows. That's right, we're cows. Such remarkable cows. We can sing very low. We can dance in a row.
Well, that doesn't happen every day, does it?
Yes, you know we are cows.
I think you're a little bit at home with this, right, Moles?
Yeah.
This is really your speed, I reckon. It's so cool.
Just busy helping out one of the farmhands, empty the food buckets that are leftovers.
Did we mention cows?
Taking 15 minutes off his job, that's all right, isn't
it? Now our number is through. Mooby dooby moo moo.
Be quick then. We're gonna pray with the team and go. Okay.
The surprise of the level of poverty amongst the Romani community, and I spent most of the time after seeing, you know, 25 people living in two rooms, thinking, what is the solution to this? And it's not straightforward.
Ambovida spretine, am laudat spretine, shall this be cei minionate, și...
Că nu-i bine, că sunt bolnav, n-am putut să fac mai bine.
I said, but
they have a totally different culture with different standards and different moral values, and it's taking real dedication on the part of the forget-me-not team to see their lives changed and conditions improved.
Nothing is impossible with you.
Noi recunoaștem că nu este nimic imposibil pentru tine.
They're tremendous faith.
in believing that the Lord could heal them, that the Lord would answer their prayers. And that for me was very, very special and very moving.
Just leave Baba in your hands at this time.
Sheila Sempe Baba in Moinali Sali.
Put other people alongside her who can help.
Been over to a place called Tinca where we've spent the day looking after orphans and visiting the Roma people. Again, a lovely experience.
Betele Danciaza.
With the family that we went to see, it was just so uplifting, but in a way that you knew it was what was supposed to be normal. Just of these little things that made this man a man of God for his family, for his wife. And it was just absolutely brilliantly godly.
But Madalena gave birth to Nelly, and so then all of the kids you see here, she's taken in everybody in her family when the kids abandoned. Her grandkids, they come and live with her. Alex was abandoned. Alex isn't their son, he's their grandson. And they've taken him in, and somebody needs loving, they bring them in.
We just thank you for that grace that we see here.
Cheers, Monsuminka, Vedem, Akuma, Haruto.
Much, much, much better than they expected.
That's wonderful. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you for the future you've got for him.
Și pentru viitorul care tu l-ai pentru el.
We pray that you'd have your hand over the paperwork.
Ne rugăm ca tu să dai favoare peste acte.
And it would all come through.
Și să fie totul cu succes.
Meeting Alex in the Roma village, the boy with Down syndrome. Not being disrespectful for them, but I wouldn't have left my dog in the Roma village unattended. Let alone my brother, so yeah, that was probably the experience I remember.
Thank you that he knows you and he loves you.
Îți mulțumim că tu-l cunoști și el te cunoaște și te iubește.
We thank you that you love him.
Îți mulțumim, Doamne, că tu-l iubești.
Amen.
Amen.
I can smell that cherry.
I know.
It was lovely just being with the women, the mummies, and hearing their stories of how they brought up their children. That for me is also was very, very profound.
Giving them a bit of a pamper, which to us in our country doesn't really seem like much at all, but these women not only live such an abusive life, but just regular people won't look at them, won't touch them or anything.
She said when she gets home, she'll massage her husband's shoulders and feet and use the stuff from you guys.
I had the honor and the privilege of washing and pedicuring the feet of some of the Roma ladies, and just that amazing moment of I don't even know how to explain it. It was just such an honor, and that moment of realizing that they thought the reason I was there was to minister to them, but in that moment just realizing that actually they were ministering to me, just allowing me to be part of their lives and part of their day and part of that moment, and just an incredible privilege really to spend time with them and just fall in love with them really.
For the ladies and all that sort of thing that entails, the work that they're doing, it's been a fantastic experience.
That God is Elroy, he is the God who sees you.
Da Domnul este Elroy, el vede și iubește pe voi toți.
That is all.
Amen, amen.
One moment probably that really stood out was just washing the ladies' hands. Just showing them love and showing them care that way, and
don't know what to.
It's getting
very slow.
I don't believe they've done that. I'm absolutely amazed at this. I'm about to show you what some of the boys have been doing for best part of 2 days at FMN with their main fence. Lloyd. I don't know what to say, dude. What a job. Mally, what on earth, dude, that you did all of this? I know there was help, I guess, who else was involved? Deacon and Joe and Molly and Millie, Josh. but it's mostly, and Josh, yeah. But this is just phenomenal. In its volume. Tool shed, sorted out. Fantastic, great job, Elliot. This space a week ago was completely crowded out. Storage and rubbish and mess. From the other center that had been brought into here and the fact that they haven't been able to give it any attention for a long time. So this has now become the women's joy beads area and the place where they have their pastoring and discussions, and it's where visiting teams can come and actually purchase the things that the Roma ladies make, and that creates an income for them and for their family. So all of these things are made from scratch, which is all good, but there was nowhere to properly put it. And now we have things like FMN t-shirts, all the bead jewelry, the woodwork stuff that they've made, candles, all merched. This week, everything hung on the wall and all of these things laid out have all been done by the team. This is predominantly Sarah's work, this is, and then the men pitched in to help get stuff up on the walls and to make it beautiful, sorting the entire business so it can be used more practically and have a great place for the ladies to come and receive and be ministered to.
So in this place, it's just an absolute...
Yeah, I couldn't move everywhere. Last time I was in here, right. Oh my word.
So Millie and Molly have done little areas like this, which is so amazing. They've sorted out all of the benches.
This week we've been ministering to people who don't know true love, and we've been showing them like the only real love that really matters in this world, which is Jesus' love.
New made in Biblia. It's in Biblia. The
Old Testament.
Good
name.
Oh, new made Biblia. Amazing how just us being there could encourage others so much.
We appreciate you.
We did electrics in one house and rendering on the other and laid the roof tiles.
I did some electricity, the rendering and things like that. And I did the roof tiles and things.
It was just the same as it was 5 years ago. They're so loyal and joyful doing their work to the highest standard that they can give.
It is better.
Yes, that one.
To dwell on the corner of a roof.
Yes, that's the one.
Than to share a house.
Yes.
Or home.
Yes.
With a nagging woman.
Right, right. Preferably your wife. What's that, Dan?
So you're allowed to say that, but not Romanians.
That's true. That is true.
You're sexist if you say that.
That's right. Exactly right.
Come on, Neil. Faster, mate.
Someone turn the speaker on.
Already had a discussion about this. Who better to fit the last tile?
I think the best moment was when we finished the roof, like finished the whole house, and laid the last tile down.
Him right there on his birthday. Yeah!
And because I got the privilege of doing that, I think that was the best moment. It was quite a nice feeling.
Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow, the rain, or the ice cold wind, whenever.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
But just take away the work that everyone does at Camel Felix and the work they do for the young children. It just blows me away, really.
Mm. Yes, Neil! Awesome job, Isaac. One final cheer, one voice of praise, right? Let's give God the thanks that he made this possible. One octave.
That sounds
amazing. The time when we all sat at the table and appreciated what everybody had done, and I was blown away at the cabbage.
And thank you all for coming on this trip. It's been one of the best in my opinion, and I've come on a lot. And I thank you and I thank God for this team.
Amen.
I haven't felt that I had served in the way that I could have. But it was just absolutely amazing to see the love that came from everybody.
We're taking a big team this year, the majority of which were newbies, and I was just desperate for people to fall in love with Romania. Desperate for it.
I've had an awesome trip.
I've been to Caminul, Felix several times before, and this must be the best.
Because there's always good food.
It's been a remarkable time, and I've thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it.
It's been an incredible experience in Romania.
It really was just an amazing 10 days.
Learned some new skills from a community perspective.
It's very perspective changing. I've been able to explore like so many new opportunities, trying new things, construction, speaking to new people, creating new relationships.
You kind of get a perspective of how other people live outside of, and you just realise how blessed we are to have what we have.
Met lots of really lovely people.
I've had a very emotional time. Well, with plenty of tears along the way. I've met some wonderful people.
And of course, just spiritually, because we've seen God's hand at work in everything we've done and through the work that's been done here in Romania.
So yeah, it's been a very good time.
The last 10 days for me have been an incredible reminder of what Christianity is actually all about and how simple it actually is.
To share about Jesus, to share the gospel with the children and the women and the men. And
just being a light where, especially in Tinca, there is just so much darkness.
Particularly enjoyed the time we spent in the Roma village.
I've invested some of my time as well in building a house, and that house will be given to people who need it.
We were just doing our best to be as much like Jesus as we could have been.
Some people need a high five in the face with a chair.
It was an excellent time. We had such an amazing team, and the team dynamic this year was just fabulous. There were so many different personalities, which gave us a lot of laughs.
When the saints
go marching in.
Saints go marching in. I wanna be in that number. Oh, when the saints go marching in.
A woman,
here we go,
shall not wear a man's garment.
Young hell.
I'm gonna be
crazy.
I've also spent a lot of my time with my friends.
The friendship that I've made, a few people on the group.
Sharing my great experiences with them.
Just got to know them really well. People that I see on a regular basis, but my friendship with them has deepened, and I've come out in a better relationship with people like that.
It's been great just going away with other Christians and having that fellowship and community.
For me, that was the most special thing.
As always, we were well received by our Romanian hosts and enjoyed their fellowship.
The zest and the desire to love those children and to bring them up in a Christian loving home is second to none.
The level of support that we've had from the organisations that we're working with.
You're sitting at a table with parents that have given up 20 years to raise kids that are not their own, that are going to give them more stress and pain than is imaginable, and they just stick at it.
We've met some lovely people who are obviously given their lives.
We got to meet Dave, which we haven't seen in a while, and it was really good to meet him.
Once you guys leave, it's just done. That's kind of the end of life, really, at that point.
Shame that we have left and arrived back in England.
The most important thing was letting these people know why we were there and why we were doing it.
The first day we came, we were told about a lot of the abuses, and one of the things that really caught me was I can't believe how awful people can be to each other.
Unfortunately, I think it takes witnessing firsthand, like experiencing, living that, to get what it means.
I've been reminded that in its simplest form, it's just loving people. And we know that Jesus said that, love God and love people. But it's been like a hands-on reminder that that is literally how simple it is, just to love other people and treat them how you would want to be treated.
And so that's what we've been doing this week, helping them feel special in the most normal way possible.
Same with us, we've got nothing if we don't have Jesus in our hearts.
They've had such joy in such horrendous circumstances.
He's the hope.
I just saw on numerous occasions, people just get wrecked. Like, their heart's broken, and I was just loving it. Like, I was just, this is it.
No, tomorrow I'll be back to normal. Possibly.
I think it's only when you're on the ground and you're holding the hand of a kid who's got a black eye because they've just been beaten up for absolutely no reason. Like, it takes seeing that and witnessing that to then just be moved to be like, what can I do?
It's easy for us to breathe in and, you know, spend 10 days and then breathe out. But we're conscious of these people who've got no end date, really. And it's just very, very challenging.
Keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. 'Cause I don't want. you have for me. I don't wanna miss, I don't wanna miss. Singing, oh Lord, show me what matters. Throw away what I'm chasing after. I don't wanna miss what you have for me.
Arguably the greatest team ever.
I did not agree to this.
Are you filming me?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, I'll go first.
I'm gonna break my
rule. What's yours, old man?
Let's not go in here.
It's soft, it's long road. Have you seen how many pictures Dan takes? He's like sat there with a thing. He did it the other day. Dane!
Well, get it right the first time.
Sorry,
then,
lads. I'm getting mixed up.
I'm not gonna lie.
It's called indigestion.
No, it's like right here.
Yeah, that's indigestion.
So you eat too much and too quickly as well.
Woman are volatile.
I don't agree.
This floor is in bone. There is no
care. If you had 60 seconds to describe the last 10 days, what would you say?
Oh my gosh. So what was the first question?
If you had 60 seconds to describe the last 10 days...
What's the question again?
What was the question?
Oh no. Okay, oh no, I've forgotten the question again.
I think that's really nice.
Go I might burst out at laughter.
Yeah.
That creamy bottle chain.
Most impacting.
Yep.
Before we get to
Yeah, that's all I have to say.
Not the voice crack.
Put it in, please.
Don't put my voice crack in.
Yeah, that's all I have to say.
Don't put my voice cracking.
That's all I have to say.
Okay then.
Okay. Highest pitch. I'm not warmed up. Huh? Doesn't matter. I'm not warmed up either.
Exactly. Very good. That's a good argument. Beat that, Lloyd. Bad. Lloyd, you're up, bruv.
Yeah! You're done.
Coral. Give it up for Coral. Give it up for Coral. Look at this. Bravo, throw the flowers and the tomatoes and everything else.
I felt the work in my body, but it was all good.
I think I helped bring some balance to that. Neil obviously worked hard, and I tried to compensate for that by using the muscles in my mouth rather than the muscles in the rest of my body. You're not going to catch me on video working, please.
My reputation. Be shot.
Oh, yay! John's helping.
Oh, no! Not you as well.
Okay. Ah! I still almost hit the wrong bit.
Your head!
Allow me to continue. Nor shall a man put on a woman's cloak. Whoever does these things.
It's an abomination.
It's an abomination to the Lord your God.
Oh,
put it back, keep get there by Christmas.
Okay, by Christmas.
I'm confident by Christmas.
You bend your knees if you want.
Yeah, bend it, it'll give it more momentum.
Wow!
That's in there.
You don't want to shame yourself for people who actually know you're able to do manual labour.
I don't. Audit it. Thing is, if it got out there, it could set a precedent.
It could, couldn't it? Anybody watching the video right now, I have his phone number if you need help.
You're right, pal. Hello, son.
You're on board. See you,
Bershire. See you later.
Lloyd, you've done it already.
It's fake.
That ain't no gospel preacher.
Shut up,
Clive. Shut up, Clive.
It's the right guy for being here.
I can't take it away.
Can't get rid of me yet.
You know the winner.
And he greeted them.
Come again next time.
Thank you.
I'm just amazed, actually.
On three.
Dave, we appreciate you.
You guys are amazing!
You're splendiferous, Dave!
You are! You are! Malik, I had a dream about coral.
Thank you!
Yes.
I might place
the dome
still for
Lloyd, don't!
Lloyd, no! Goodbye!
No! Lloyd, stop!
Lloyd, you're gonna make yourself.
You're gonna get brain damage, Lloyd!
What
happened?
What would you do?
Are you okay?
How long has
she had braces
for?
I've got
some
ones for quite a while.
Really good. Your lens is filthy, Millie. Look at it. It's like a soft focus filter.
Yeah, but I was filming. I couldn't do it during. Oh, it's during.
That's mine.
Carrying on going. It's going to be ridiculous.
Switch to POV. Make sure you stay on the right side of the road.
Yeah, Lloyd.
Right. Enjoy.
The whole thing in one?
Yeah.
Yes. I don't know what you're on about.
That's what I do when I'm on.
Oh, it stings! Oh! My stomach!
Yeah, it's burning a bit, right?
A bit, yeah! A lot!
Just some coke.
No, leave it settle for now, it's just cleansing him.
Oh! That was good.
I've been told it hurts, so I wanted to see for myself.
People do to his eyes.
Oh yeah. Keep dusting. Drop some coral. Don't lie to me.
Stop it.
You can keep that.
Different one.
Ready?
Sip and dip and swallow.
No.
Don't miss
Victor, your feedback on this performance.
I'm sorry.
Like, I'm Simon Cowell now. It's a good show.
No one will believe me unless I have photographic evidence that you would sit here with naked feet on a mission trip. Got you then. Yes, now, as many of you will probably remember, Tony decided to stay back for a day or so in Debrecen while we flew home. Here's Tony pictured with a local couple outside of a famous church in Debrecen. Here's Tony helping out at a traditional Hungarian horse riding exhibition. Here's Tony in a building site where a very important factory will be built in the next year or so. And here's Tony checking out some of the local wildlife.
Wait. Where's Ellie?
Yo!
Sings my soul.